We're really happy to be here. The group, Windsong Consort, is originally located in Temecula. And we have three of the members are from Temecula. We have a San Diego member, and I'm the one from here from the Valley. So, we are very fortunate to be in this venue to perform. So this is our first time out here. And that was Three Shanties by Malcolm Arnold. He wrote some very, very cool, as I like to put it, cool wind music that uses a lot of color and technique on the instruments. Great piece for a quintet, which uses all those techniques and things like that. Our next piece that we're gonna do is by Vincent Persichetti. He's an American composer who wrote this pastorale, and pastorale is a piece that depicts nature scenes. I like to picture horses and things like that, and you know, whatever you like to imagine. But Vincent's pastorale is a gorgeous piece that uses all the different instruments in different ways. So enjoy the pastorale by Vincent Persichetti.
to you is actually the West Coast premiere of a newly composed piece by Daniel Dorr. Now, Daniel Dorr is a living composer, and the only living composer that we're performing, although Robert Kuczynski, that we're performing after this, just died, I believe, last year. Yeah, a couple years ago. Wonderful composer. Daniel Dorr actually studied with Vincent Persichetti, and briefly, Vincent Persichetti was on staff at Juilliard as a composer, and composed in a very beautiful lyrical language, which is what you're going to hear somewhat in Cape May Breezes. Now, Cape May, who knows where Cape May is? Oh, so you've got some people going down there. Now, down the shore, I learned. I said, go to the beach. And they said, oh no, what are you crazy? You're from the West Coast. It's down the shore. The Jersey Shore, Cape May, is this beautiful, idyllic town. These colored Victorian houses and gardens all around. It's just a darling, charming town on the Jersey Shore. There's always a breeze going. We're out here, and we actually made concert in the library this afternoon. We didn't play Cape May Breezes, but we certainly wish we were filling some breezes. This is a five-movement piece, so even though you may wish to clap between movements, there is a structure to them, so resist that urge and we'll blow into your applause at the end of it. Breezing into town, exit zero. There actually is an exit zero. That's the first exit you get to when you get into town. Now, the monarchs, when they migrate in autumn, go through there. And it, like you see it, it evidently is just truly cloud orange when you see the monarch. People go there, and sometimes they catch it, sometimes they miss it, but it's truly beautiful. And we'll hear some fluttering, I think. The Victorian Garden Party, we're a group within a group. So basically, we're the performers. And performing different dances, so there's three different dances within Dusk at Sunset Beach. At Sunset Beach, every night, they do a flag, take the flag down. And so you're going to hear a little taps in that, because they do a memorial at that for veterans. Because there were, this was an important place during the Civil War. And then the night breezes on the boardwalk, you know, evening, you've got fireworks, you we film it's just a real problem. So enjoy this West Coast premiere. You're the first ones to hear it on the West Coast.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, and thanks so much for coming. That, of course, is the most recent work on the program because it was finished this year.
Yeah. Yes, it premiered it March 31st.
Yeah, it was premiered just a couple months ago. The second most recent work on the program is this quintet by Robert Grushinski, and it was written in 1985, which in contemporary music is contemporary indeed, because they still consider, like, The Rite of Spring, which was in 1913, and Pierre Girard-Brunner, also 1913, to be contemporary music. So 1985, oh, it's an infant, just a little bit. But Robert Grushinski wrote music. He died only recently, within the last couple of years. He was pretty old. He was at the University of Chicago, head of the composition department, and wrote a tremendous amount of chamber music, as well as larger works, but he's mostly known for his chamber music. He was highly influenced by folk music of Eastern Europe, Russia, actually, all over the world he did a lot. So in that respect, he's a lot like Bartok and Prokofiev. And you'll hear some of that in the piece we're about to play. It's four movements. The third and fourth movement go right into each other. And if you feel like clapping between movements, just say, hey, have fun.
Thank you.
Thanks, and thanks again for coming. Wow, it's so good to see so many people. We were thinking there'd be more of us up here than you and I. Didn't seem to be the case. Thanks so much. We're going to end with a march, the Radetzky March by Strauss. It's not a waltz.
I'm saying no.